I'll always remember the Tuesday of the incident. We were sitting at roll call, concluding roll call, and the run came out about the pursuit. Nick jumping up and getting his mic and strapping on and getting ready to go out there to be a team player and to help not only his coworkers, but to help the community.
We truly, truly lost a good man. And over the next few days, I hope that everyone in this community gets an opportunity to learn just who Nick Rodman was and what great things he did for this community.
Nick Rodman was, he was an amazing, amazing person.
He really made me feel like a brother.
He was definitely a leader of this platoon.
I learned a lot from him.
He was very patient.
He always made me laugh.
He's kind of the glue that held all this stuff together.
I will always remember how relaxed he was.
He was always that calming force.
I never told him I took some of his techniques, but I definitely did. The way he can just calm people down is just, it's something a lot of people can't do.
He would get even the biggest person, you know how little Nick is, to take it easy.
Nick was one of those people that was just his demeanor, it was his personality that he wouldn't overreact. And that's a very integral role with any unit.
There was nothing that he used to get frustrated about.
He taught me how to relax and just talk to people.
He always kept me calm. I tend to get a little, frustrated with people, and he'd always keep me calm.
He was always there to back you up no matter what. No matter what was going on, he was always there.
We're gonna miss that. We're gonna miss it a whole bunch.
He was big on his family.
Nick taught me how to Nick taught me what it meant to be in a family. In fact, the whole Rodman family, they accepted everyone.
Back in October, him and his family, George and Andy, they put together a bus trip down to Cincinnati to go to a Bengals game, a large bus. That's just the kind of people they are, the kind of family they are.
He could relate to me better than anyone on my platoon because I'm from a police family. Both of my parents are police officers, and his father was one too. So when I came down here, I rolled with him a few times when I was brand new. I always liked riding with him because it was easy to talk to if I had to talk about it with somebody.
He had a lifetime to learn how to do this job, so learning all of the life lessons and everything from his dad is what made him a great police officer.
He was a great police officer, but the best part of Nick, and you know, the best thing that I knew, was Nick the father.
Nothing made him happier than when he talked about his children. His eyes would always light up, and Ashley.
He was one of the, if not the best dad I've ever seen.
I'm a father myself, but Nick, he was a great father. He always talked about his kids.
I want Nick's kids to know when they grow up that their father was a good man. He's a hard worker. And that he gave his life serving his community.
He was truly a hero. He was an amazing dad. You will miss out on a lot of his life, but the 2 years and the 6 weeks you had him, he cared about you more than anything.
I think they will know that. They'll be surrounded by good family and good friends. I don't really worry about that.
I know Mason started soccer this year, and me and Nick will talk about that often because my kids play soccer also. So he was excited to get that started and excited to get that part of his, you know, being that sports dad, excited to get that part of his life started.
Feel really bad for the first guy to take that little girl out on a date because we're all gonna be there waiting.
I just want, you know, Ashley and Mason and Ellie to know that you know, we're not gonna let people forget about him.
They're never gonna be alone, and they're never gonna be without a dad, because Nick will always be there.
His babies will always know his father was a great person.
They'll never leave our minds.
When his kids get older, they're gonna know who Nick was, and I'm gonna make sure of that.
The best part of working with Nick was how much fun he always had.
I'll always remember just how big of a smile Nick always had on his face. There wasn't a day that went by that you worked with him that he didn't make you laugh or smile or just put you in a better mood.
My favorite memories of Nick would have to be tailgating at the U of L games.
We all know that he's a big U of L fan, and I am as well. That was one of the biggest things between me and him. We would get together and remind each other when to take off and when the games are.
He gave me a ticket to go to the Florida State game. He told me that because of how well they played, I had a ticket whenever I wanted one, because he said I was good luck.
He was the one always getting everybody together to do things as a platoon and as a department.
No matter if it was a long day, we were getting call to call to call, or it was snowing, there was nothing going on, we always had fun.
He had a wonderful sense of humor. Kind of, we all cut up anyway, but he was the one that kind of just made everybody laugh, even on like stressful scenes or stressful nights. You know, you could count on Nick for that.
If I did something wrong, that was the best part about it. I was looking forward to being made fun of by Nick.
To his final days, he always was happy.
He came to work as hard as he worked. That's just as hard as he played. He enjoyed life and he enjoyed work.
And I really just want the community to know just how good of a person Nick really was and what he really did for this city. And many people don't really see what happens behind closed doors or behind the police cars closed doors when Nick was out actually serving the community, helping people, getting people to the hospital, getting people where they needed to be.
About a year ago, I was injured on the job, and Nick really put everything on the line to save me. I was shot back in June, and Nick was there. He drug me to the hospital. I remember looking up and seeing him, and he just kept telling me it would be okay. I'll never forget that.
If I could be half the officer Nick was, it'd be a dream come true, because Nick was, he was a good officer.
You are selfless. So I embody that now, man. I continue to, continue to hold each other accountable.
I know that we all on the platoon really want to make sure we live up to Nick's legacy, both as a cop down here and as a husband and a dad to our families, because he did everything with a joy and a smile on his face, and that's how we should all strive to live every day.
He's just a good person. He's a good police officer, a good person in general.
He accepted everyone. That was one of the best parts about working with him.
We just got along. We knew how each other operated.
He just really made me feel comfortable, like I've been a friend to him for a long time.
I owe everything to him and his family. He was a real hero for me, because I would have never made it in there if it wasn't for him.
He was an excellent officer, and he really loved this city, and he really loved the community.
He really cared for each individual citizen. This was more than a job to him, it was a calling.
He was a great police officer because of how much he cared about the job growing up.
I'll always remember him because of the impact he had on people. Not just us, the people he worked with, or his family, but the community. With this event and the outpour of the community support, that's the impact that Nick had.
We miss him every day, and we still talk about him every day. We'll never forget him.
You're going to be missed, but you're never forgotten, but you're always in my heart, man. Yeah, brother, you're always going to ride with me.
He will for always and forever be my B partner.
I'm definitely going to miss seeing him and seeing that big grin that he has in all those pictures around the roll call table.
I'm missing. I will for a very long time.
Love you, Nick. Miss you, man.